we are. We're in Port Arkansas, southeast coast of Texas. Hurricane Harvey is intensifying about 12 hours from landfall here. Shut down anyway, so nobody's going out there. This area that we're in here. So we're waiting for some. It's pretty impressive. The date is August 25th, 2017. Okay, that little white circle is our location. There's what's coming right towards us. We're probably going to get right almost dead center in that eye, hopefully. Time's about 2:32. We're still about 30 miles to the beginning of the eye wall, so maybe this will come in before dark, hopefully. This is kind of where we're at. Right there, and that's coming towards us. So about 3 or 4 hours away right now. Of course, these bands are affecting us now up here. great. Strong wind there. Thank you.
helpful convective downdraft coming in.
Cool. like the eye wall is starting to move in now. Time is about 7:06 Central. Still in Rockport. Gonna have some major damage in here. This is a Category 4 storm now. Winds are sustained at 130 pressure, 9.41 millibars, according to NHC. And that was at the 5 p.m. advisory. So basically, we got a large tornado coming into this area almost. That's what it's like. Power's still on in a lot of areas, which is good. It ain't gonna be on too much longer. I'm about a mile inland now. There goes the power flash. Okay, now we have to move into the car. The car is here, and I'm hoping nothing's going to blow off this thing and do any damage. I had to leave the car. Josh there, Josh Morgan, he's here.
Definitely will be, guys.
What?
Firemen in here.
Yeah, no, they're not going to be doing eating. The fire department's not going to come out.
Can I go get them?
You can, yes, but they will not.
You think I can get over the bridge right now?
I don't know. They shut that thing down once they get 60, but obviously your guy got on the other side.
No, he's coming from the north.
Oh, okay. So I don't know if Texas has that shut down or
not. Where is that?
Wow.
Oh, yell all you want. You ain't gonna hear yourself yelling a while.
Right. Oh.
Oh my God.
There it goes. Power's gone.
Fly on the building. Watch out.
Yeah, watch out. Bricks are falling off of the building. We're in Rockport, Texas. Rockport, Texas.
Watch your back. We're going to fly under the hood.
Island might create a new inlet. I've seen that.
Trying to find him?
Help him.
nose 90.
I'd have had my wheel. We'll go about that way.
Give it a second.
That is. Go.
It's like a big rain wrap tornado. It's power flashes over there. Man, I hope this guy makes it. He better make it, right?
Now, I don't think we're getting back. Awesome. Look at the van rocking right in front of us, guys. Look at the van rocking.
Man, my car's still on.
Get the van rocking, son.
I know.
That might be it.
Relentless.
Yeah. Power flash right on there.
Man,
if you look in there, your eyes go contact them.
We're definitely not walking.
lights are those?
Oh, we got headlights. We got headlights for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's turning in.
Oh, good. Yes.
Yep,
is that him?
Back. Yes. Yes. Now we can enjoy the cane.
Yep. Yeah, now we get to do
thank
it.
Thank God. Is it him?
I don't know.
I hope.
A big truck?
Yeah.
Looks like
okay.
It.
Oh.
I can't do a lot right now. Are you kidding me? This guy. This is a once in a lifetime opportunity. Situation. Is the car still turning in? Where'd that car go?
It turned in, it looks like.
Beach ball.
Hey, beach ball.
Beach ball.
Dust coming, shit. Hope he doesn't.
Here it is, about to call me.
Inside.
Yeah. The van is on the line here.
glass?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's glass.
What happened?
Glass flying out there.
Not why.
Oh! Alright, get the hell in here, guys. Keep the sandbags in there. Come on, go, go, go! Water. There's water coming in here though. Right, we don't want to be near these windows in case they blow out. Kind of almost got to do the same thing we do in tornadoes. We have to go to the lowest floor and away from windows in an interior room. And there's windows here. You don't want to be near that. So we are leaking in here. As you can see, there's water coming in here. Let's see what's on the other side over here. Clean the lens here. Supposedly had an electrical fire here. I could smell it.
Chris, I finally did it.
What's that?
Between Matthew and all the others, I finally got the eyewall of a major.
Yeah.
I didn't deflect it. The curse is over. I didn't deflect the eyewall of a major.
Dude, it's slowing down.
We were coming across the causeways. The eyewall was coming in.
I can't believe you were over the causeway in this shit, dude.
You should see. We couldn't see the road in front of us. We were crawling, and the car was almost flipping.
I've never seen anything like this, man.
I broke my curse.
Good.
Remember Matthew?
It's kind of wobbling.
At both times.
It is wobbling.
I think we're still going to get in it. It's going to be a while, that's all.
Yes, sir. I'm all right with a slow
Mike arm. Scantlin. Storm chaser, which we're not really got going on.
Luggage car?
What's up?
It needs a luggage car.
Oh.
What's going on?
Somebody hurt?
Yeah. What's
the whole wall up there is, you can see it separating from the stairwell, right where the stairwell meets the wall.
Oh, jeez.
That whole side wall is about to pull off the building if this wind keeps up like it is.
Shit. So this whole thing could collapse on this side.
Well, no, but it'll lose that facade. It'll be like the Hilton and Ike down by NASA.
Oh, jeez. God, that smell is terrible.
That's the hydraulic fluid of the elevator.
Oh, yeah, okay.
They always smell like that.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, I worked in hotels. Wait till the guy goes. But the whole wall, this whole side wall, is pulsating and pulling away from the stairways. Yeah, we gotta wait for the guy to come down because he doesn't want any of us up there.
We got one of the facades on the front of the building's currently disintegrating. It's pulling away from the staircase. There is a medical emergency. Somebody upstairs might need to help them out.
Stay here, please.
Calm down, huh? Doing what you asked.
Goodness gracious. No, you wanted to continue to walk.
I explained what I was doing.
Yeah.
Hold on. I know you can't see much. This is just kind of what's going on. We have lightning in the eyewall.
That green lightning, you see that? Turquoise color. Wow.
I'll let him tell his story on his own behalf, so I won't say much more about that. But he is saying that he is at this hotel right now.
Baritonicity.
I mean, it's almost taking a hexagonal
shape.
Anybody
got a charger, an iPhone charger? I'm at 3%.
Probably land
I'm
interaction.
I'm at 10%. I'm out. Yeah, here, let me get video.
Wow, that's crazy.
That's amazing. That's good. I hear a loud
one. Yeah, just pretty insane. We're,
you notice
we're
before a big wind gust,
right,
you can,
here in Rockport, and you can see.
So we're waiting probably a couple of more hours, and we'll get into the pressure center of the eye, and it'll. It should get calm outside soon. And everybody's in here. Got quite a few chasers in here.
how strong this category 4 is. How much relief inside is.
This is fresh water, by the way. It's not surged, fortunately. In a hurricane, the water's pressurized in the rain sideways, so the whole lobby's flooding. It's coming in on one side of the building. Yeah, it's definitely not power flash. That's frequent lightning in the eye wall. That's impressive.
Steven, do you have extra batteries for these AX100s?
Hey, let's go.
Well, we're not opening the door to the outside. It makes no difference if we're right here.
Yeah.
Hanging in there.
Yeah, it's pretty much F5 tornado. The one side's 200 miles an hour and the other side's 5 miles an hour. Yeah. Out of the same direction.
Absolutely. Yeah, out of the same direction.
Quite a gradient. Oh my god. Oh, look at those.
Hey, see?
Are you sleeping next? Well, maybe you should pull your head out of here.
How's the other side of the eyeball look?
So much water in the already.
I bet those are birds and mosquito. Birds,
you know, that could be birds.
Yeah.
I hope they're tasty.
Hit the. Nah, it looks like birds fluffing around.
Are birds low carb?
Look at that thin wheel.
Hey, well, they are high protein.
We're gonna need the food.
High protein.
Look at that polygonal line. Yeah, wow.
Hey, we got ham sandwiches in our room.
Oh, that sounds amazing. Music's a
Oh, geez. Oh, cool. Yeah. We're on the inner surface. Okay, beautiful.
It looks like it, yeah. I mean, if the winds are verifying in this strongest part of the storm, which is where we are, 130 mile an hour winds is what we're listening to. We were talking about the leaks coming in through the window over there. We still see pouring in. It sounds like the windows are about to blow through at any moment. So we've been reassured that these hurricane made of glass, but it's kind of terrifying.
This is one of those stories where, of course, as journalists and of course as media lawyers, you try and see the facts. Although it's only important, you try and see all of the.
Feel the pressure in your ears, very bad. The whole building's shaking pretty substantially. Don't want to be near that if that blows.
I can't believe there's as much standing as there is still. Ooh, there goes something.
Yeah, tight. I said that's gust to 135, and I believe him.
Yeah. Look at that news van. There goes something. God. What if it just like starts retrograding, we go back through the rest of the island?
Screw that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. No thanks.
So apparently the roof or something of the La Quinta blew off onto somebody's truck
onto,
or something?
Yeah, one of Brett's guys.
Oh, hi. Hi. They just got really mad at Reed and Bart for going outside.
They went outside? Oh,
yeah.
Well, yeah. Dude, look at the
God
wind.
Damn.
Dude, that is insane.
I cannot believe.
This is more intense than I even expected.
Yeah. Yeah.
What a cane. That I don't know if that news van's gonna last. Look at it.
I guess it's about on par with what I expected, but I mean, it's just as mind-blowing as it would have been if it wasn't. Like,
it's kind of heavy, though.
Look at all the water in the lot.
Steve's car looks okay.
There's wow a lot of water in the parking lot.
Yeah, there is. I think it's...
Doubt it surged though, but remember,
yeah,
it's just horizontal rain. It's like it goes sideways. It's pressurized.
There's been a ton of rain.
Yeah.
But I'm, you know, Josh Morgerman, whatever, has chased a lot more hurricanes than I have. So.
What? Because I.
You're sure that's not Clement?
He doesn't have side lights like that.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Oh my gosh.
God, that turn is going to be so dicey.
Dude, those mobile homes and those trailers, those people in those
gone
fucking trailers that
there's,
we saw.
There's people in RVs a mile
they're,
south
they're
of
dead.
Yeah, they're all fucked up.
They're either dead or not having a very good time currently.
I hope they got out of there. Yeah,
I don't think they did, man. There were a bunch of them with their doors open hanging out.
Yeah. And they were saying how, you know, their grandfather's been here since.
Yes.
That don't mean anything because there's always a, this, it's just a matter of time until we get something like this.
Is that a storm chaser? It might be. They're shooting damage like with.
SWAT's just shooting loose.
I'm saying that really might be Clement.
Oh my god.
He's getting nailed with that gust.
Wow.
Oh my god.
I'm not worried about like the car getting thrown. I'm worried about taking debris through the windshield.
Yeah.
Yeah, a piece of sheet metal, just boom. There's been sheet metal flying.
Can you feel the building?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, put your back up against the wall.
The building has been rocking.
Clear Mac, or Mike.
Oh man, that is nuts. Yeah, lean against the wall. What was that?
He almost got hit with something.
SWAT team going just hardcore out there. Oh, dude, so that is insane.
Look at that tree.
Got bolts on, guys.
Oh, my God. Wow.
Yeah, that dude balls a steel award right there.
I wonder if we're in one of those meso vortices.
Maybe. I'm sure we were.
During those really intense periods.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my goodness.
I would not be in a car right now.
Oh, there goes a mini
ear
swirl.
My ears popped.
Yeah,
that's a vortex going by.
Yeah, it is.
Wow.
Now the wind's going to catch up a second later. There it is. That's a mini swirl.
Yeah.
Did you get that on
watch
video?
For the shift. Yeah. Watch for the shift.
I don't think you'll see it. You'll just see the wind let up like it is now.
Right,
maybe.
But it's
like in the backside?
Rotation when the winds are going 150
forward
miles per hour. It manifests as like slightly less wind speed here and slightly more over here. Like
extremely cool.
Horizontal flooding?
That's so crazy.
Goodness.
God, if it was daytime.
I know. Yeah. I'm. You know, I can't complain too much because we got a good show while it was still light out. I thought
he was just trying to boogie it.
That is Clement.
Yeah, that is, I think.
Let's go run out to him.
Let's go on, tell him to roll down this window.
Mike Tice has seen his fair share of intense hurricanes.
Sorry.
What is that?
That's a camera.
Okay.
I felt water on my back.
So good.
God, I wish my camera could pick up what's happening right there. You got a 1-inch sensor, dude. Shoot that shit.
1-inch sensor. Well, see, this is the current issue.
Battery?
Yeah.
Bart said he was going to get me another one. That was half an hour
ago. Oh my God, dude, look what the water's doing. That's crazy.
That's what I was saying.
That's what I was.
This is nuts. You've been in this eyewall for like...
It's been 3 hours.
Yeah, it's just been a super long eyewall experience, huh?
Getting real intense. Do you have AT&T? I have 4G right now on AT&T.
Really?
Do you have the Wi-Fi?
Yeah. Probably going to check on those broken windows that are up there.
And are there the broken windows up there?
Yeah, there's broken windows and supposedly part of the roof is gone.
Fuck this hotel.
Just kidding.
Yeah. That guy like lost it at me.
Yeah, he really tore you a new butt. Yeah, well, you got to realize we're in a...
This is not
a storm chase. This is a disaster.
Like, I was walking down the hallway, and he, like, yelled at me. I stood there and argued, because that's me. And now I kind of wanted to be like, sorry for arguing with you. I know you are under stress. I'm not. I'm loving the shit out of this.
We're almost in the eye.
I'm curious to see where those...
Almost in the eye of...
Dude, I can't wait to see if my truck is still alive.
The back window is probably gone.
Lots of damage.
Yeah. Where are you parked?
On the front.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. Now that Bart isn't there.
He's gonna die.
My ears are popping again, dude.
You have shitty ears.
Mine too.
No, mine work.
Yeah. My eardrums are a lot younger than your guys' are. Because I've ruptured your eardrums a couple times. I'm a disgusting human being. And it feels so good. Is that it?
I think we're
starting to lull?
Definitely, but I mean, with the...
There's glass on the side of that structure, almost gone.
Oh, yeah.
Like the whole wall of the stairwell.
Yeah, it's gone.
Wow. On the other stairwell, is that
what it is? Yes, there's a stairwell.
Okay.
We need a stairwell on this side, in case that side collapses in a little bit.
All right.
We have the structure over here.
I mean, if you look at the radar, we are on the edge of the eye, on the edge of the clearing. So really, any moment, this is about to turn from 100 plus mile an hour wind to nothing.
Light poles.
This is incredible. There's a, I don't know if you can see it, just beyond that car though, there's a light pole that's about to break. This is a reporter from Houston, what? I believe. Which is so hard to commend. A bunch of people coming and going. Sort of a crazy scene in here. Shout out to you guys. See this now. Pretty incredible.
We're almost in the eye here. Shouldn't be too long. Completely open to the outside world.
Going out?
The eye. I think we're in the eye.
Go ahead, go, yeah. Go ahead, guys.
Thank you.
Nice, your bag is drenched. We lost a window.
Okay. Well, at this point, right?
also that happened. And also watch shots. There's some horse skating.
We're obviously in the eye. We're just entering the eye here.
Are we done with those boats? Are we done with those boats?
Which back? Oh, shit.
Brett.
Yeah.
Brett, can you borrow one of your stoning?
I pointed the hood in right after the window popped. So you were in the car, right out the front. Whoa, we're not as wet back here as we think. We're in the parking bay. It's not a parking bay. It's not so gorgeous. We're home.
We're almost in the eye here. We're on the inner surface of it. Mezzolos. Stars overhead, so we're officially in the eye. Stars peeking through. Birds flying up there,
yeah,
too.
Reporting live from Rockport, Robert Arm, KBRC, Channel 2.
Thank you.
evacuate the area, didn't come here, and they say it's about the only place that they felt safe. We also have a lot of storm chasers in this area. This is where they've set up shop to try and get as much information, as much data as they can. But for now, things are a little bit calm, and hopefully it will not, that back half will not be nearly as rough as that. What am I talking about? Robert Arnold.
Alright, who else needs rides? Are y'all good?
Sucks. I'm still in the eye here. And since we're in the eye, I might as well check the damage. Pressure's very low in here. Be about 940 millibars or lower. Wow, I can actually feel myself get winded going up the stairs. Jeez, I never had that before. Pressure's very low. No, I don't.
Here. Bring it back down to me.
All right, where are you going to be?
I'm downstairs.
Okay, downstairs in the lobby?
Be careful.
Yeah, be careful.
All right.
Dude, this thing is badly compromised. If you look in this room right here, you can see where what's left of this ceiling was separating from this wall, this interior wall. You can see we're separating from the interior wall.
Wow.
So, I mean, when we get on the other side, if you lose that other facade, the roof's gonna come off, and then who knows what keeps coming off.
Yeah.
We gotta get out of here.
Oh, almighty. I would not want to be up here when that happened.
How about in here? Is that not the creepiest thing you've ever seen?
Jesus. That's crazy.
Did you see this? The curtains on the third floor got sucked out of the building, or on the second floor got sucked out of the building between the walls and are now poking out on the outside.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
No problem. Let's get out of here.
Yeah.
Are you going to stay here?
No.
Is this where you were on the fourth floor? Is that where you're staying?
No, I'm not. I don't even have a room here.
Oh, okay. It's completely, the side of the building's gone. So basically, you're just looking right at the, basically, you're just walking right up to the edge there, and you can just fall right out. Staircase is gone and everything. Just incredible.
We're not safe anymore. It's a wood frame building. The sheetrock is soaked. It's just going to come, and it's going to be bad times.
We should go to the school, right? Is that where we're going?
The school's a reinforced concrete structure.
Okay, cool.
And that's what the government shelter is here.
Okay. stars overhead, right up there. I don't know if it's coming out on video at all.
Wow.
Look at the stadium effect. You can see the whole frick. Okay, we got the second half coming now. Wind shifted 180 degrees. It's coming from the other direction now. Harvey part two.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Look. Welcome back, Pete.
Oh, fine. I'm sorry.
is the next morning on the 26th, I believe. It's the first light, and we think it's going to extend the true grim revelation of the damage here. Water just coming in everywhere here. Luckily, I was able to just catch a few hours of sleep here for the night. Yeah, we're gonna, what are we doing?
By word. If you have questions concerning this matter, you can contact the city at 826-1208. Power outage has affected the city wastewater treatment plant. The city of Corpus Christi is asking all residents to please reduce the use of their toilets and faucets. The request is a result of power outages at the wastewater treatment plants, evidently having problems handling the load. Repairs will take place once conditions are favorable, and the city will notify residents when the plants are back in full operation.
This is during the morning of the 27th of August. Obviously, I'm not getting out of here. That's the road going to Houston Airport. Obviously, everything's been canceled, so I'm going to be stuck here for a while, but this is kind of the scene here. We actually had 42 inches of rain fall here. So this is probably one of the less flooded areas, just to show you.
Now this water is actually going down, just so you know. This water's falling rapidly. This water was actually over the road before. That's looking up towards the airport. The airport is there, up that way. So obviously, we're not getting out of here for a while.
Situation we have going on in Houston. Again, Mike Meltzer and Sean Pendergast, and the ways to get in touch with us, 713-572-4610. Let's go right now to the hotline. Brian Green, he is with the Houston Food Bank. Brian, Mike, and Sean, how are you this morning?
Mike and Sean, we're hanging in here. Just like I think everybody in the community, we're just trying to do our best.
So I guess the first thing, and absolutely, the first thing is, in terms of donations, can people donate to the Houston Food Bank right now? And if so, how can they do so?
So far we've had the supply to meet what the hospitals are needing, but I'm not going to sugarcoat it. It's going to be a critical situation once this storm's over. So it's going to be...
And we're getting squeezed down to one lane by a constable. I'll just tell you briefly, we found out this morning that our area of Birth Colony in Sugar Land was an area where we were required to evacuate, mandatory. And we left the house probably about an hour and a half ago. We were told
the buses for evacuations.
Highway 6 north toward Katy. We'd be able to...
Yeah, well, that's right. And Constellation Field is a shelter right now, too. Rich Lord is on the hotline with us. Rich, when you left your house, was the water, had the water crept into your house, or was this just one of those mandatory evacuations?
Some of the areas totally impassable. They've been closed for a few days now.
Oh, this water went down a lot Shepherd, here.
There was a Randall's that I saw was open. Also, the HEB there in Alabama was open, but the lines are ridiculous right now. And also, yes, sir, taco truck.
The plan is to get out of Houston, period. Just get out of here and try to work our way up to Dallas. And I'm leaving tonight instead of tomorrow morning. I don't want to take any chances here. There's the Astrodome there. We're basically evacuating here. Get the hell out of here. What is this? Down here, there could be water there. Shit. Jesus God, this is crazy here. Fucking guy stopping for.
The bayou will either hold fairly steady or possibly rise only about a half a foot to a foot, and that would be on the upper end, the maximum. And so we are at this time not expecting significant additional flooding along the Buffalo Bayou due to the current controlled releases from the Anderson Barker reservoirs. Obviously, with additional rainfall and with the runoff continuing with the the most accurate information to pass along to you all, both on the reservoir pools, the releases, and the
impact. Flooded, guys. Shit. Fuck.
So I'll take any questions.
That was too scary. I haven't seen that in a while, blue sky. And the sun's coming up. Looking southeast from Dallas, there's Harvey in the distance over the horizon.